Matthew's studio equipment was founded in 1968, back in the day when studios generally designed their own grip gear. The company went public in 1989, but the modern iteration of MSE Grip came into being when Ed Phillips bought the company in 1998. I sat down with Ed's son, Tyler Phillips, and asked him about working with his dad, being LA-based, and whether their longevity gets them taken for granted or is a positive.
It's a positive. I love working with my father. He's my best friend. We get along very well. From a consumer standpoint, I think people appreciate buying a product from a company that's been around for almost 50 years as opposed to buying a product from a newbie company or a knockoff company, because they know they can call here or email or Facebook or whatever they want to do to get a hold of us to get service, parts, questions. And I think it's a total positive. When my father bought this building, this 50,000 square foot building that we're sitting in now, he bought it in this location in Burbank because when people come to Los Angeles, they're coming to see a number of companies. I don't have to name those companies. There's dozens of them. But when people come to visit manufacturers, they come to Burbank. So we stayed in Burbank and will continue to stay in Burbank.
I asked Tyler who buys their products.
Our main customers are, it's kind of a variety. It's the major studios, it's the major rental houses, and it's our channel partners. We've got a number of dealers throughout Los Angeles and all over the world that sell our product to people like YouTubers, production companies, people with vans and trucks. And, you know, it's a wide range, but really those three.
Things like light stands are a commodity product, and that can lead to copies. I asked Tyler their views on the knockoff market and how they innovate.
Infuriating, yeah, it upsets us. Copying pisses me off. Copying certainly upsets me, but you know what they say, copying is the cheapest form of R&D, and I say that's bullshit. But the day they stop copying us is the day we'll start worrying. We never steal ideas. We're straight shooters. We have integrity. And, you know, just so you know, so the audience knows, if somebody comes to us with an idea and we like it, and we get a lot of ideas, but if we end up working together with that person or that group of people, there's always a payout and a partnership, I guess you would say.
During an exclusive look at their manufacturing facilities, it's obvious that in addition to making quality gear, there's also a lot of pride in doing things right and providing good jobs for their workforce.
We've got 7 full-time welders. All these air hoses are exhaust systems to suck up any of the fumes you might get from a weld. And it filters those fumes and puts clean air back out into the atmosphere. So right now it looks like we're welding a lot of frames and Max Menace arms. These are Max Menace arm parts. Those are 4x4 frames. These are legs, I think, for our new monitor stands. These are legs, I think, for Mambo combos. This is our sewing department. We do all of our flags, scrims, overheads, green screens. Anything fabric related is sewn and done in this department.
Manufacturing is a balance here. We've got CNCs, we've got CAD software, we use SolidWorks to design all of our products, even if it's going to be ran on a conventional lathe or handmade. But yeah, we're totally into SolidWorks, 3D CAD. We still use manual lathes, manual mills, but that's more for short run product, for custom product, because we do custom work. But the majority of the products we make are CNC'd. We don't do the castings here, but we do have local shops that do the casting for us. And those are mostly used for brake housings on our stands. It's a balance. It's, you know, you've got handmade work, you've got a lot of CNC, you've got automatic saws. It's a wide range because we've got 1,400 products in our catalog and on our website. So that requires us to be able to accommodate a variety of different manufacturing processes.
So now we're in the warehouse. Everything's made, everything's boxed, everything's packaged. If you look down the aisles here, we've got anything from Mambo combos to Max Menace arms to crank evaders to monitor stands. If you look up, we've got a couple thousand C stands ready to be shipped
whenever you need them. You know, this industry is kind of, I always need it, or I needed it yesterday. So we're always trying to be prepared to have things in stock for when you need it.
Okay. It's Kelly on a tangent, big scoop time. What do you got in development that you can tell me about?
In development? We've got a lot in development.
Specifics, Tyler, specifics.
I can't talk about everything, but one last and final weird, I'm going to call it weird because it's not really our thing or our market, is a line of furniture we've been working on. I can't get too specific, but we're taking standard grip gear and making furniture out of it, whether it's tables, desk lamps or standard lamps, lighting fixtures for home decor, office decor. And I think you'll probably see that come out in a few months. You may see some of it behind me right now, but it's something we've been building for years. We've built stuff for the Local 80 Grip Union. We've built stuff for James Cameron and Vince Pace. We've built stuff for some of our big clients in the Philippines. And if you look around our showroom and around our offices, we have a number of tables and desk style pieces made out of your standard grip equipment. And I think you'll see a lot more of that coming out soon.